kicking off now with some strikes. We can thank Cindy Dandois for that. Here we go. Touch of gloves. We are underway. Anderson coming out hard. Dandois. Talk about her submission grappling. She has two KOs on her record as well in mixed martial arts.
She does. She holds her chin just a little bit too high for my liking, and she backs up quite a bit. But once she gets a hold of you, she wants to take you to the mat and sub you.
Anderson pawing with that jab. Dandois definitely moving here, covering up. Anderson teeing off now with some strikes. Cindy Dandois goes for a takedown. She gets it. Oh. Look at Anderson trying to roll through. Dandois now inside.
Great hips by Dandois, keeping that. She was almost swept.
Cindy Dandois in her world early. This is exactly where she wanted the fight. Just under a minute in, Julie.
Yeah, and her braid's getting in her mouth. Needs to pull that out.
Stay heavy on that left underhook.
Let her go! Let her go!
Crowd getting involved in the let it go theme. Cindy's transitioning over, trying to get to mount. She's got a little bit of a high hip ride going on right here. Anderson's trying to stretch her out. But again, Cindy has some pretty good hips. She's able to ride things very, very well to get her position.
Dandois using that right leg to try to make some space. Step over to mount. Now she's in quarter guard. Now into full. Could not have gone more perfect for Cindy Dandois thus far in this fight, getting exactly where she wants to be. Now she postures up. Right hand, nice elbow, gets through. Anderson trying to bring up those legs high to buck off Cindy Dandois. Dandois, a good grappler. She shouldn't get thrown off by that.
No, I don't think so. You know, I would like to see her get a little bit more power in those ground strikes, get a little bit, you know, more length for that. Now, look at the way Cindy is grabbing around her head and Misha's saying, let go of her head, let go of her head. That's very important. That's how you get swept. You do not want to hold onto your opponent's head when you're full mounted.
We talk a lot about the reach and the height of Anderson. She's trying to use that height to possibly buck and sweep, but now she gives up her back. Cindy Dandois going for an armbar, Julie.
Very nice transition from Dandois. Good read of that.
She gave up position here too, so if Anderson gets out, she will be on top. But now Dandois going belly down. Not able to do so now, still keeping the pressure on it. Now Megan Anderson looking to put the knee on the face here.
That's a smart strategy to be able to pull out your arm. You have to create some sort of push-pull action to get good leverage.
We'll see if Anderson tries to just stand up and get out of this position. Look at Dandois with those hips high. Now from a very high guard. Now she's going for a triangle. She might have this. She needs to pass the right hand of Anderson's out here to fully cinch this in. Now she does.
Anderson gave it to her. That's very nice of Cindy. Good read. Like I said, she's squirmy on the ground. She moves around. Her hips are very flexible. She hits you with things you wouldn't expect.
Megan Anderson, the biggest favorite on the sporting books online. Cindy Dandois trying to pull off a submission upset here of Megan Anderson. Working this triangle. Anderson okay for the time being, but this is deep. Throwing off the posture here of Dandois. Well, that's very tight, Julie. Now she might finish this on
that
top.
That was well done of her to use that to transition to mount. They can stop from strikes here. She's not able to defend herself, Anderson, on the bottom very well when her arms are pinned.
Some right hands here by Dandois. She's got a locked in submission, but still going to throw some strikes. And a lot of time here for Cindy Dandois to do work, 75 seconds.
I like the way she cleared her foot earlier from the cage. That's a good strategy.
Dandois trying to finish it here.
Oh, Anderson is
Megan
out.
Anderson able to get out.
Using
big sigh
those
relief.
Legs. Very nicely done.
Now right hands here from Anderson. Dandois trying to roll through. She's going to go to her back. Megan Anderson wisely escapes the position, stands up, makes Dandois engage back on the feet. Anderson again pawing that jab.
And see how tall Cindy stands? That's a lot of ground to be hit with. You really want to keep your knees a little bit more bent as a fighter, but she also just completely dominated the first few minutes of this fight.
Sure, Anderson, you know, needs to be aggressive but can't give up another takedown.
No.
She does need to do something. She wants to steal this round, though. A big hit, flurry could do something, but right now this round firmly in the corner of Cindy Dandois. Anderson Anderson lands a right hand. Dandois going for a throw. She's going to run out of time here. Here we go, round two underway. Anderson versus Dandois. Look at Cindy Dandois immediately rushing forward, trying to get this throw. Anderson could capitalize, but Dandois solidifies the position, now on top in half.
I think the first round gave Cindy a lot of confidence because she just straight Frankenstein walked in with her hands that time. She didn't even bother punching or dealing with punches. I think she's got a lot of confidence right now.
See, Anderson flowering for the right leg there of Dandois. Dandois's got to be cognizant of those up kicks. Now she gets kind of thrown off there. Anderson, credit to her, back to her feet.
Anderson needs to get very aggressive on her feet right now. Don't stand there, move. I'm sorry, I shouldn't be cornering.
But we see Dandois here, you know, very flat-footed.
Yes.
Just kind of measuring Anderson, waiting for Anderson to move before she's not advancing forward at all.
No, sort and of counterattacking is not going to work for Anderson
right
here because Cindy's
not hard right
hand
throw there by Megan Anderson.
She should have confidence from that.
That woke up Dandois. Dandois fired back and started to move.
Dandois just looking for a chance to take her down, to grab onto her. She's going to claw that hand, grab onto it.
I would say she's counter-striking, but she's counter-grappling.
Yeah, she's counter-grabbing.
Now she goes to her back. This could be just as good for Cindy Dandois. Not on top, but still in her world now on the floor.
What's amazing about this unorthodox approach that Cindy has, this basically no-striking approach that she has, is it throws Anderson off of her game. Anderson's not doing enough.
She passed the arm quite nicely there of Anderson, not locking up a triangle yet, but definitely in position to. And there she does, locks up that triangle, pulls down now on the head. Anderson was in this position in the first round, was able to survive. You don't want to be in this position too many times, though. Dandois will catch you.
Yeah, and Anderson also had the cage to work her way out of it when it rolled through to the mounted triangle. She doesn't have a cage for that anymore. She has to use technique here.
Dandois now pulling on the head, trying to cut off the blood circulation to the brain of Anderson. Anderson now trying to push Dandois back to the fence. Saw Dandois try to switch it up. I haven't seen that reverse triangle position before.
There's really very little explosiveness in Cindy's attacks. She just moves fluidly.
She makes it look easy, really, Julie.
She does. She makes it look like, okay, you just grab their hand and go through to this.
Halfway point of this fight.
Oh,
there it is, it's done. Megan Anderson couldn't hang out very long. That was reminiscent of Livia Souza's triangle over Katia Kankampo.
Ladies and gentlemen, the end comes at the official time. 2:41, round number two, submission by triangle for your winner, the Battle Cat, Cindy Dandois.